Why is it that the desires that we find deep in our hearts are so far from the life that we find ourselves living? There was a heart that we had as a boy, filled with wonder and dreams of battle, adventure, beauty. And somewhere in the process of boy to man, most of us lose heart. And in order to find the life that we are still looking for, we have to go back. We have to get those lost parts of our heart back. We're going to go straight to Genesis chapter 1 and hear what he said in the beginning. Genesis 1:26, God says, "Let us make man in our image, in our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air, over the livestock, over all the earth, and over all the creatures that move along the ground." And then here's the key point. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created us, male and female. He created them. Male and female, he created us. This is an absolutely incredible passage because right here in the beginning, it tells us who we are. It tells us what we're created as. It tells us that gender is at the level of the soul. You bear God's image as a man. You have a masculine heart, a masculine soul. And this is going to help so many men and women because we live in a time right now that's really confused about what it means to be male and female. Is all that just socially constructed? But see, if we know who we are, if we know what we were designed to be, it helps us make sense of our story and it helps us plan for our lives. This is a hard time to be a man on the earth. If we're honest, this is a pretty rough time to be male, because there's a lot of confusion and anger and hostility around questions of masculinity. And so what I love is that Jesus, the kindest, most compassionate man ever, right in the middle of his redemptive mission for humanity, he quotes this passage. And he says in Matthew, "Haven't you heard that in the beginning, the Creator made them male and female?" Male and female, gender, the dignity, the honor of that. The most important thing you can know about yourself, my brother, is that you bear God's image, you are His son, and that you bear His image in your masculine heart, in your masculine soul. Now, I want to add to this another passage from the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, one of my favorites. Proverbs 4:23 says, "Above all else, guard your heart, for from it flows the wellspring of life." It's this heart in us that allows us to love our life. Without a heart, you can't have friends. Without a heart, you can't have joy. It's your heart that allows you to fall in love. It's your heart that lets you find adventures. It's your heart that gives you the passion to pursue your degree or find your career, your calling. It is the heart that enables us to know God. And here's the heartache. A lot of men are losing heart in this hour. A lot of people are losing heart. And I think part of it is because we don't know the treasure of the gift that's been put within us in Genesis 1, in the masculine heart, or in the feminine heart. So that's the journey that we're going to take together.